So you're interested in career progression promotions and pay rises and how they're related to each other. And when you come into these discussions, it's always a nervous time as you don't know whether you're going to get negative feedback or whether the manager is going to encourage you with what you're currently doing. So it's always good to go into it with a plan. I'm going to give a brief discussion about what each one of them are and how they're related to each other and how I approach them and something that's helped me throughout my 15 years experience as a structural engineer. Hi, my name's Brendan. I'm your structural engineer based in Australia, and I produce videos that help progress your career faster in the field of structural engineering, and just some general engineering advice as well. So let's get into it. So I'm going to go into detail about each one of these experiences. However, one thing I'm really passionate about is separating career progression from both promotion and pay rise discussions, as there's a lot of emotions brought into when you're discussing about promotions and pay rises. So it really clouds your judgment when you're looking at your career progression, which is the thing that really helps you out throughout your career. So if you can, wherever possible, try and separate them. Now, yes, they are related and they do help you get to your goals. However, you should try and separate them, as it will really help you focus on where you need to be going for your career progression and not cloud it with the judgment of how you get that next pay rise or how do you get to that next promotion. Now, career progression. What is it and what should it be focusing on? And why should it be separated from promotion and pay rises? As I said, it will help you get to your goals of that next promotion and that next pay rise. However, there is little goals that you need to make along the way through to achieve this. And this is where your career progression discussions really come in. So, for example, as a structural engineer, have you got those different types of designs? Have you designed a post-tension slab? Have you designed enough columns? Have you done a whole stability model? These are type of areas which you can say you want to focus on as a structural engineer. And when you get further in your career, you can go, I want to start running projects. I want to start managing that flow from project management. I want to get that experience on quoting on projects. So these are different experiences that have different realms of experience that you need to drill down on. So this is rarely where you're having a discussion with your manager saying, I want to focus on these areas. You want to be discussing a more broad range of topics about areas you should be focusing on. So you're not just focusing just on those technical skills, but potentially also focusing on those soft skills. So helping managing clients, also helping quote for those projects. So when you're having that career progression discussion, it's not just focusing on just one thing. So it's not just focusing on your technical skills and not just focusing on your soft skills either, as you need both of these to be successful. However, it's broadening those experiences. When you're at the start of your career, yes, there'll be a lot more technical base to try and get that broad experience across the different design fields. Or when you're moving your later in your career, moving into more of those soft skills, like dealing with clients, quoting on projects, and making sure that project is on budget. However, if you do bring it into those different discussions with promotion and pay rises, it clouds your judgment and doesn't make you see the real goal of what you're trying to achieve, as you do not want to be just focusing on that next promotion and pay rise, as it does take time and you need to show your dedication. Another area is having those little discussions with your manager off to the side during the year. So it's not just that one mid-year or end-of-year discussion with your manager. Having little discussions, having little check-ins with them. They do not need to be formal, but saying, look, I think I'm missing these types of experiences. This will show you that you are dedicated towards your career, and it will actually help you in those next discussions as they see that you're really serious about progressing your career and helping out the company. So when you're talking about career progression, it's not even just focusing just on different types of experience on project work, although that does help. There may be outside courses that you may be able to go on that may actually help you progress your career as well. So looking out for those different opportunities and asking your manager, is this something I should be focusing on? The company may actually offer to help pay for some of that, or they might even have internal courses that you can go on to help you out. By having these discussions, again, it's about you looking to progress your career the way you want to go. As your manager does not know what you want to focus on, it's something that you need to take into your own hands, as you do have a long career and you want to make sure that you're focusing on the right stuff, something that you enjoy. Now, how about pay rises? This is already a touchy subject, both for your manager and for yourself as well, as they want to try and get you for as least as possible. So you need to do a couple of things, and it's about forward planning. As a lot of the time, once you've come into that meeting, it's really too late, as they've already allocated their pay rises to different areas. Then they may have some budget to move, but it'd be very limited. So what you want to be doing is talking to your manager, planting that seed in their mind, not going directly out and asking them for that pay rise necessarily before you go into those meetings, but showing them that you are dedicated and that you've done additional responsibilities that have helped the company and have grown value to that company. So when you come and have that discussion with them, you can lay them down saying, this is the things that I've done and that I've taken on additional responsibilities and I feel that I've added a benefit to the company. Now, this will not always work. And so potentially when you're in those meetings, they're saying, well, what can I do to get that next position? Because I really think I'm valued. However, what additional things can I do to help you out to try and get that additional pay rise that you're looking for? Pay rises are also not just about working hard, although that is a really critical aspect. It's about a couple of things. You need to add value to the company, but also then go out to them and say, this is what I want to do. Showing them that you are a go-getter and that for them to keep you, they need to give you that additional asset. So it's about you going to them and saying, this is what I want to achieve. This is what I want to get out of my career. I've been trying to help out the company, add additional value as well, and that I feel that I'm actually worth more. So it's about telling them about your feelings. And then potentially they will come back and say, look, we don't have money at the time or some other reasons. But it's saying then, what can I do to prove to you that I am valued to that? So setting some little goals and then potentially coming back in a couple of months' time and saying, I've achieved those goals. Have I not achieved those goals? And that way you've got some sort of recourse to go back and forth and some way to aim for that additional pay rise. What it is, and this is really what I want to emphasize, is that you improving their value to the company. As they do have a limited pool, and companies are not charities. They need to earn money. So you need to prove to them about why you should get paid more and that the benefit that you're adding to them. As potentially they can go out and find someone else and that someone else may be cheaper. But are they as good as you? So it's about you adding that additional value and making yourself invaluable to that company. So it's really a two-way street here. As you need to show them about why you should get paid more, but you got to realize that they are a business. They are there to make money. And that you are not there just along for the ride. You need to show them that you want to try and help promote them as a company and add value to them. And not just skip them out when we get to the next role, as some people may. And then say that you are dedicated to that company. So there is a couple of things you need to do. It's about talking to your manager about what problems do you have that I can potentially solve? How can I add additional value to the company? And you may even be looking around about different areas that you can focus on to help that. And it's about you coming out and coming to them and saying, this is what I've added to you. And I think that it's added additional value to the company. And letting them know, do you disagree or not? Now, how about promotions? Now, promotions are probably one of your biggest assets to get that pay rise, as it makes it a lot easier for your manager to come saying, look, they've taken on additional responsibilities. We feel that they've stepped up and they've got that to that next position. So when you're going for that promotion and you think you're going to get there, it's about doing a lot of research before you get in that door, as you want to know what type of pay rise do you want to get out of this. And this is really your biggest time to negotiate with them because of those two reasons, is that you have taken on that additional responsibility. They've shown that by giving you that promotion, as they've seen, yes, you are stepped up to the next role. And also for your managers, it's easier for them to go to the other people and say, well, he has taken those additional responsibilities on and he's earned it and he's got that promotion. So it's a lot easier for them to get that acceptance through the different charts. And now if you are going for that promotion and you are talking to your manager about it, again, it's about taking on those responsibilities before you actually get there. As you need to prove yourself that you have stepped up to that next position, that you are valued and that you have done those additional roles and you can achieve them successfully. It's not about just getting that additional promotion and then stepping up. You really need to do this before. Now, promotions are also done well and truly before you've gone into that door. So you want to be drilling down throughout the whole year, showing you them you are dedicated, stepping up wherever you can, asking for those additional responsibilities, taking on those additional responsibilities throughout the year, helping out your manager through little different problems that he has. It's all about separating those career progression discussions from both your pay rises and promotion discussions, because if you do blur them, it doesn't make you focus on each one of them. And it brings the emotions in, especially about pay rises, which can confuse you and not help you progress your career further. So I would recommend you, wherever possible, separate these discussions in your mind and separate these discussions with your manager, as this will both help you progress your career faster. Because yes, career progression is your key aspect and it will help you get those pay rises and promotions, but there's potentially little steps you need to make along the way. And you want to make sure that you are focusing on achieving those little steps instead of just trying to jump ahead to get that next position, as it will hinder you in the long run. So if you have any other additional comments that can help people out when you're having those discussions, please comment below. And if you do like these content, please like, comment, and subscribe. I look forward to seeing you in the next episode and hope you enjoy. See you later. See you in the next episode. Now, as I said, you want to separate your discussions between promotions and pay rises.